Hello everyone, Catweazle here. Welcome to the channel and welcome back to A Touch of Evil, the Banshee, turn 7. Sorry there's been a bit of a delay, but I've got a cold. I've also got a shocking sore throat, so we'll see how we go on. So you may get away with me not talking as much this episode, but don't bank on it. Righto, here we are. We're at the player area. Our first player is going to be Sara, the Bright Witch. And to start off, as usual, she's going to use her Strength of Light. And she is going to get 2 additional investigation, which puts her on to 12. Which is funky. Right. So, having done that, what are we going to do? I can't remember if I got anything wrong last episode. I think I did change a couple of things. I think I had to move the shadow track down to 18 because we got the, Echoes of the Moors twice, and I forgot to move it down during the video, but in between I have moved it. I don't think there was anything else. I think I did catch up with anything if there's something I've forgotten in the meantime. Righty-ho. So our first player is Sara the Bright Witch. So what we're going to do is let's move across. She's just outside the monastery and let's start the hero phase, shall we? And here we are at Echo Lake with Sara. So let's roll for movement. And we get a 3. That's more than enough. Because all we're doing is we're moving into the monastery. So her and the widow Jessica move into there. Now, there are no minions, so that's fine. Nobody to fight. So, encounter the space. So, we'll do that before we get around to reading the text here. Let's just encounter the monastery. See what happens. Again, just shuffling these just to show it's a random draw. And secret ritual, investigation, danger. Inspecting the grounds at night, you come across a dark ritual performed by cloaked worshippers. Gathered around a bonfire, the chanting draws you closer. Make a cunning 6+ test and gain 3 investigation for each 6 rolled. If failed, you are attacked by the Order of the Crimson Hand. Right, what's her?
Her cunning is a rubbish 2. She can't even use the Widow Jessica's cunning because that is a rubbish 1. So, 2 dice. Oh, she's got 1 6. The other one fell out. Try not to hit the other one. Yay! She gets 3 investigations. She rocks. 1, 2, 3. So that's brilliant. And she doesn't get attacked. She's now up to 15 investigation. Woohoo! Spending spree imminent. Right, so discard that. Put the monastery cards back. Excellent. Righty ho, so what's next? Don't think we'll be rolling for anything else. Yeah, let's get rid of that. End of the way. Right. So we can buy monastery items here and we're going to. So let's have a look at the monastery items. You can look at everything. So let's see what's the most expensive first. Ooh, an 8. That's expensive. That's just crossbow because it's a weapon. She can't use guns. Oh, that counts as a gun. So forget that. That was a crossbow, a gun. Crying out loud. Holy water, oath of devotion, robes, just get you an extra wound. Ooh, a flail. +2 combat. Right, let's have a look at these two. The monastery item deck, the coastal town item, you can just look through them all. They're sort of all on offer. So what does the sacred chalice do? Well, it gives +1 spirit. Oh. Unfortunately, it's holy. I thought we might be able to hand it off to Valeria, but she can't have holy stuff. Plus one spirit, plus one honour. You may cancel any event or mystery card. Woohoo! After each use, roll a d6. On the roll of 1 or a 2, remove Sacred Chalice from the game. We've got 4 in play. I think it might be the same as the other one, whereby we've got to cancel them as they come out. So, but the flail now counts as 2 items against the carrying limit. Well, that's fine. She's only got an Oath of Honour. And what is it? I don't think the Widow Jessica counts. She's an ally. And that is plus 2 combat. And we do use combat against the Banshee. It's only her minions we use spirit against, or cunning. So, I'm going to take the flail. Let's take the flail. She can't use guns, but the flail isn't a gun. It's just a hand weapon, so we're laughing, right? So, Secret Chalice can go back. We're going to spend 7 investigation and get the flail. So, there you go. Have a quick look at that. The plus 2 combat will put her up to 5 combat. She'll be a beast. Brilliant. In fact, we might even hand it over to Eliza, whose combat's rubbish at 2. So, cool. Right, let's pay for it. So, she's back down to 8 investigation now. And there's the 7 that she's paid. Brilliant. Right, what else? If attack while lingering here, well, we weren't lingering, so that's fine. And what else? Ooh, we could heal a wound. We have got one wound and we are going to heal it. So we're going to go down to 5 investigation. Because we're going to spend 3 to get rid of this wound. So she's fully healed now. We're not going to collect any investigation from the board. There aren't any. We're not going to investigate any elders, we're not going to buy a lair card, we're not going to start a showdown, and we're not going to exchange any cards. So, oh, I forgot to zoom in. Let's just zoom in. Here we are zoomed in. Apologies for that. But there's just the monastery. Buy monastery items here, and if attacked while lingering here, we'd be fighting the Order of the Crimson Hand, but we weren't lingering. So that is where she is. But now we must away, and we must find Valeria, who is in the town square at Tidewater. So let's bob across to good old Valeria. And here we are with Valeria. So let's roll for movement. 3 again. Right, so she's going to move 1 space. All she's going to do is move to the beach. So move that down. Let's zoom in. And here we are at the beach. And as you can see, there's absolutely no minions, so we don't have to bother about that. So, what are we going to do? Well, first of all, we're going to draw a village encounter. So, remember, these aren't corner encounters. And we don't discard any. They go right back in. So, let's give them a cut. Let's see what we get. Founder's Rock. Well, she's found the Founder's Journal. Now she's found Founder's Rock. Village encounter. A massive stone embedded in the sandy beach. The Founder's Rock marks the first landing at Tidewater and the founding of the town in 1626. Roll a d6. So, let's have a quick look. 1 to 2 will move the shadow trap 1 step closer to darkness. 3 to 4 will draw an event card. 5 to 6 will move the shadow's track 1 step away. So, we need a good roll, people. Come on. A 3! We draw an event card. So, whew, at least we didn't have to move the shadow track. So, let's get the event deck. Crap shuffle. A cut. Let's see what we get. Spirited attack. And she looks spirited, doesn't she? Oh, indeed. Right, event spirit. Play on any hero, including yourself, to allow them to add their spirit to their combat for 1 fight round. Right. So we're not going to play it on ourselves because our spirit's rubbish at 2. Yeah, so just let you have a look at that while I look across at the player area. So Eliza's got 4 spirit and Sarah's got 4 spirit. So, and they've both got 4 wounds due to various cards and whatnot. In fact, we'll play it on Sarah because Sarah's still got the Widow Jessica. Even if the Widow Jessica does one, Sarah's got 4 spirit, which is just as high as Eliza's. So she will get this card. Let's give it to Sarah. So, brilliant. Valeria has an alright turn. Stunner. As mentioned, this goes back into the deck. It doesn't get discarded. Put that over here. Right, what else at the beach? Ah, yes, the real reason I went here. Widow's Cottage, heal 1 wound. We haven't got a curse, so we can ignore that. But we do have a wound. So we've got rid of that. Woohoo! Right, so what next? Are there any investigations to pick up? No, they're not. Heal a wound? No need to do that because we use the Widow's Cottage to do that. We're not going to investigate an elder. We are going to buy a lair card. The Shadow Track is at 18, which means a lair card costs 12. We do have 12. Going to use all our investigation. So there we go, 12 investigation. And we are going to find out where the Banshee is, where she's hiding out. Now we don't have to start a showdown immediately, because, well, we have to get somebody there first. But even if somebody's there, we don't have to start the showdown immediately. It's up to us when we do it. So let's do a cut. Where's the Banshee? The crossroads. The crossroads. She's got about another 400 years to wait for a certain blues man, but she's at the crossroads. So at the. So that's pretty cool. That's over on. In fact, it's right on the right hand side, isn't it, of the Shadowbrook board. So it should be quite easy for somebody to get to. As I say, this is just saying where the Banshee is going to be. So, keep that next to Valeria. So we know that the Banshee is now hiding out at the crossroads. Cool. Right, we're not going to start a showdown, as I mentioned. We're not going to do it quite yet. We want to get a bit more tooled up. And she's not going to exchange any cards or do any trading. There's nobody there with her. So excellent, excellent stuff from Valeria. She's done really well that turn. Brilliant. We could still do with getting her a spirit from somewhere because she is still susceptible to the Banshee's spectre ability. But we'll keep an eye out for something. Right, that is it for Valeria and her hero phase. Next up is Eliza, the witch hunter, and she's over at the doctor's office in Shadowbrook. So let's get over there. And here we are with Eliza, the doctor's office. Let's roll for movement. A 3. We just keep rolling 3s for movement, but that's fine because we want to move to the town hall and then to the blacksmith. So that's cool. There are no minions on the board, so we don't have to fight anybody. So we are straight into let's encounter the space. So, first of all, we draw an event. More crap shuffling. Another cut. And we get Strength of Battle. Play immediately. Play this card on any hero. That hero immediately gains +1 combat marker. This is going to go on Eliza, because her combat's rubbish at 2. So she's now going to get a combat of 3. Excellent. Let's put it over there to remind us. Let's get rid of these. Get the plus one combat marker as well. Let's do it right. Yeah, excellent. Okay, now we've done that, let's zoom in. Should have zoomed in. Let's zoom in on the space so we can read it. Won't be a second. Here we are, that's a bit better. Right, so we've drawn the event, but now we have to what we want to do is to buy town items. So again, we've got the full deck. Some people play a house rule whereby they only draw the top three. You are allowed to look at them all. But to make it a bit harder, some people just draw the top three. I think Doug Herring has it as a house rule. But as this is my first play, I'm not using any house rules. But very similar to the house rule about going minions being able to move to Tidewater Town Square if it's nearer. This is one I like as well, where you only pick three, yeah, rather than the whole deck. But first playthrough, I'm going to play it as is. But just be aware that there is a house rule where you can just pick three rather than look through the whole deck. Right, but I'm going to look through the whole deck. It's my first play, so let's have a look. Ooh, a musket. Oh, we've only got seven investigation. Damn it! I'd have had that if I'd had enough investigation, but I haven't. So, let's get rid of that. Ooh, malicious soldier. We can afford that for seven. Each time a wound is assigned to a malicious soldier, roll a d6. Discard him on a one. Alright, so you don't even have to get rid of him straight away. You only discard him on a one. Yes, he's a definite possibility. So, get rid of musket, we can't afford it. Captain of the Watch, can't afford him either, he's an 8. Old map, horse, we're not bothered about movement. Two horses, Book of Law. No. Is it better than a militia soldier? I don't think so. Padded jacket, she's got four wounds anyway. Runic amulet, that's an 8, can't use that. Healing herbs. Nah. Another militia soldier. I've already got one down there. Old map, nah. Ooh, a pistol. Well, that's only plus one combat. We get plus one combat with the militia soldier anyway, and we get a wound, so nope. Silver shot's 10, we can't have that. Pistol. Torch, you may ignore the keyword weather. Force a few rerolls, nah. Tools of science are 8, can't afford them. Torch, healing herbs. Plus one cunning. Book of town history, nah. Charmed relic. Nah. Old map, horse. Book of law, padded jacket. No, we're going to stick with the militia soldier. So let's just put these back. Excuse me. So there he is. So you get a wound and you get plus one combat. And each time a wound is assigned to him, you've got to roll a d6. We only discard him on a roll of one. Woohoo! So let's put him over with Eliza. She's going to spend her 7 investigation. So she's met a malicious soldier in the blacksmith. He was probably getting, I don't know, was probably getting his sword sharpened or something. And she's managed to co-opt him in to the fight against evil, which is brilliant. Right, what after that? Well, no investigation to collect. We don't have to heal the wound, she hasn't got any. We're not going to investigate an elder. We're not going to buy a lair card, start a showdown, or exchange any cards or gear. So that is the end of her hero phase, I think. So that is the end of the hero phase altogether. So what we'll do is we'll get set up for the laugh and chuckle phase. And here we are at Shadowbrook. Strangely enough, we've got a crow cawing outside the window, if you can hear it. It's not the soundtrack. So, how thematic's that? Right, anyway,
Let's get on with it. So here we are. Let's just go over where everybody is. So Sara, our first player, she made it to the monastery. She's there with the widow Jessica. Our next player, Valeria, she's here at the beach, where she managed to find out where the Banshee is, and she also managed to heal a wound. So brilliant, she's here. She also got us a very useful I think she got us a very useful event card as well that she gave to Sara. So cool, she had a good turn, brilliant. And our last player this turn was the lovely Eliza, who's here at the blacksmith, where she's managed to co-opt a militia soldier to our cause. Brilliant. And she also got a pretty good event card. So she has now got... Ooh, she's now up to 4 combat with the militia soldier and the... what's it called? Strength of Battle event card. So that's a good turn for her as well. Brilliant. Pity she couldn't afford the musket. But... what is it? I think Sara managed to get a flail from the monastery, so that's good. So I just thought I'd go through the good stuff before we start on the bad stuff. Yes, it's the mystery phase. Let's get on with it. Right, so minion movement. We've got no minions. There's only a haunting on the board. That's not moving. So skip that. There's no KO'd heroes, so we're fine there. The villain doesn't need to heal, hasn't took any wounds, so that's brilliant. Don't have to do that. So we roll on the Advanced Cooperative Mystery Phase chart. If I can pick it up. Come on. There we go. Right. So, 2 black dice. And we get a 10. Oh, have we had this one? Ambush, I think we have. Every hero must roll a d6 and add their cunning. Whoever has the lowest result immediately attacked by one of the villain's minions, which we've got to roll off if it's tied. Right, we'll do the... We'll find out who first. Right, first player is Sara, and her cunning is 2. And she's got no bonuses. Even the widow Jessica has only got a cunning of 1. So, her... Net score is 4. Valeria's got a cunning of 3. In fact, she's got more than 3, I think. Yeah, she got plus 1 cunning from the Founder's Journal. So she's actually got 7. 4 plus 3 is 7. And Eliza has got a cunning of 4. 5, 6. She ends up with 10. So poor old Sara. He's going to get ambushed in the monastery. Let's have a read. So we roll on the villain minion chart, re-rolling any event result or minion that has no fight dice, and place that minion in the hero's space. I think that means they're just going to get a barrow shade. I don't think there's no groundskeeper anymore. Banshee attacks an event, and the Echo of the Moors is an event, so we don't even need to roll. It's going to be a barrow shade. Let's dig one out. Woo! Pop that in the monastery. Let's zoom in at the monastery and see how the fight goes. And here we are at the monastery, and it's bad. It's bad news. It's an ambush. So the bloody barrow shade gets twice its normal fight dice. Its normal fight dice is 3. So it's going to have 6. And then it doesn't stop there because it gets plus 1. It gets a bonus fight dice for full moon. So it's got 7. So 7 black dice for the barrow shade. Poor old Sara, she cannot use any of her allies or abilities. So the 6 spirit from the widow Jessica can't use it. Bummer. And it's... Yeah, we have had this one before. It was terrible before. So we've got 7 fight dice. She's only got 4 spirit. She's got to fight it with spirit. So we get 4 dice. The barrel shade gets 7. Nightmare. Oh, oh, have we got lucky? That is 1-5. So that's a hit. But we got a 6. That's a hit.
Nobody else hit. Yes! Right, so that's one wound each. Barrow Shade goes down to one wound, I think. Yes, it got two wounds. So that's down to one wound. We have still got four wounds. No, three. We're down to three. So we'll put that onto her. Oh, let's put it on here so everybody knows. Right, so she's got one wound. And this boy's got one wound. We're going to fight again. We're not going to run off. I was thinking we might run off if... let's get rid of that. That was its success. We'll keep sad dice. Keep the sad dice. It's going to get four because it's back to normal attacks now. Get rid of those. And we are going to get... We're going to keep that six because that's happy dice. Keep that happy six. And now, let's calculate our dice because we can use all our abilities now. So we're going to use the Widow Jessica, which is six spirit. Woohoo! And, oh, we're not going to use spirited attack. We're going to save that. I think you've got to discard it when you play it, spirited attack. So we'll just do the six attack we get with the Widow Jessica. So we get six dice, and the barricade gets four. Come on! Look at that. Damn. Right, bloody typical. Right, it hits on every single dice, so both of us are knocked out. So that goes, it counts as a win for us, because if this gets killed at the same time we're knocked out, it's a win for us. So we do get the four investigation for defeating it. What I did forget is the Widow Jessica could have rolled to get rid of that wound that she had. Doesn't matter, because even if we'd got rid of it, it rolled four successes, so it'd have got us anyway. So the fact that I forgot for Widow Jessica to roll for the wound is moot, but I should have remembered Widow Jessica should have rolled to try and get rid of that wound. How unlucky was that? Look at that. Bugger. Right, for everybody who says I'm dead lucky, not all the time. So that was a bit of a blow. Oh, I'm not going to have much success against a Banshee if I roll like that. Right. I mean, I could have played just a scratch as well, I suppose, and stayed alive, but I want to save that for the showdown. Righto, so... She gets knocked out, which means the Widow Jessica leaves the board. Because as soon as you're knocked out, that's what happens, I believe. Let's check her secret. Anytime the Shadow Track crosses into a new stage, or if you are KO'd, immediately return the Elder to town. So we've done that. So it's happened during the mystery phase as well, so it means we miss the whole of the next turn, which is grim. Because we've already had that phase of the turn where KO'd heroes could stand up. So we've missed it. So we've got to wait till next turn now. She gets moved to the nearest space. I imagine that being KO'd is very similar to moving the minions. If we're not using any house rules, I believe this means she will go to the town hall. So I've moved her across to the Shadowbrook board. Hang on, I'll zoom out. Hello everyone, Catweazle here. Just noticed during editing, when Sara got knocked down,
Knocked out. Obviously, I've got to roll a d6. She's got to lose that many investigation. So, a 5. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. A bloody 5. Right. So, she pays 5. She's not going to lose any of her items, obviously. That leaves her with 2. I did notice also during editing, I flashed a few things across the screen, but obviously the shadow track went down 2 as well because she got knocked out. So because she got knocked out, shadow track goes down 2 because of Veil of Darkness. So instead of having 9 investigations, she went down to 7. Fortunately, 2 of those investigations go on to Valeria because she actually gained investigation when the shadow trap moves. So I'll go back to editing now, and you can watch the rest of the mystery phase. Ta-ta! Right, there we go. So she's been taken to town hall by the monks. So, damn. Right, other things we've got to do. Don't move the shadow trap because it's a hero that gets knocked out, so that's fine. Oh, we do move the shadow track, do we? Because of Veil of Darkness. Yeah, if a hero is KO'd. So, damn. So, that moves it 2. We'd have lost the Widow anyway, because we go over one of those lines. So let me sort this out. And she gets plus 2 wounds, the Banshee. So, brilliant. She's basically on plus 5 wounds, what with that and the boatman. Ugh. Mystery phase. Crap. Right. So I think I've caught that. I think that's everything to do with her being knocked out. 4 successes on 1 roll. Can't believe it. Right, right, so that is the Advanced Cooperative Mystery Phase chart. Bah! Right, oh, I better check. Let's just check the Banshee itself, just in case there's something special on there. Willow Wisps. She gets another plus 1 marker. So, look at that. With the Boatman, she's got plus 6 wounds. No, she's at 18 wounds. That's grim. Right. I think that's it. I think I've caught it all now. Let me know if I haven't. Oh, what a nightmare. After such a good hero phase, this mystery phase is pants. And we haven't even turned over the mystery card yet. And that's what we've got to do now. Rubbish shuffling. And let's see what the bad news is. The Order's Influence. I'm sick of the Order's Influence. We've got about 4 of these cards. Play this card on Dr. Manning while he is alive. Any hero in the Doctor's office space at the start of the mystery phase must pass a cunning 5 plus test or take D6 hits. If he is dead or join the villain, discard and move the shadow trap 1 step closer to darkness. Healing. I'm afraid tonight it will be a sacrifice. It doesn't actually make him evil though, does it? He's not evil. He's not joined the villain. But I would like... No, nobody will need any healing because when Sara like stands up next turn, she heals, doesn't she? Nobody else has got any. I can leave this in play, can't I? Let me know if I've got to put this, you know, if this is one to put on the Loveless Pendant
but I think we'll be all right. As long as he doesn't join the villain, I don't see... I don't see it being a problem. He hasn't. I don't think it stops you. I don't think it stops him from joining you or anything. In the hunting party, it's just like the order have got some sort of hypnosis over him. So if ever he performs some sort of surgery, he'll try and hurt you. So yeah, we'll leave that. I think that's okay. Let me know if it isn't. And we will put it on the Loveless Pendant and give Valeria a wound. But I think we'll be alright. Right, so that's it for the mystery phase. And it's crap. We, of course, it's gone to 8 now. It's the Shadow Track's gone down to where a lair card costs 8. We've already spent 12. Damn it! And, yeah, the most disappointing thing about that turn was that Barrow Shade. It had 4 dice. And it gets four successes on 4 dice. Don't believe it. Right, that was just to prove my sad dice, happy dice theory wrong. But anyway, apart from that, we did pretty well. We got a good weapon in the flail. We got a couple of good event cards. And we managed to boost Eliza's combat, which is good. We know where the Banshee's hiding out. It's a crossroads. So let's get a bit more gear and let's just sort it out. We don't want many mystery phases like the last one. Just be getting stronger and stronger. The Banshee's got +5 wounds now. So 6 if you count the traitorous boatman. Traitorous boatface who's joined her. So she's on 18 wounds that we'll have to get off her. So let's get some decent gear and then start a showdown. Right, so that's it. Okay, so that is the end of turn 7 and A Touch of Evil, the Banshee. Thanks very much for watching. Thanks very much for all your subscriptions, for all your help, for all your support, for all the comments. They are very much appreciated. Thank you. And as ever, those of you that bobbed across to Board Game Links to upvote the site, thank you very much as well. I hope that if you've spotted any horrendous errors or cock-ups that I've done, that you'll put them in the comments. I will do my best to fix them if I don't notice them myself during editing or whatever. So, yes, I think that is it for turn 7. I hope you join me for turn 8 of A Touch of Evil, the Banshee. But until then, this is me, Catweazle, saying toodaloo.